Well, hi, I'm Adobe Stock artist, evangelist, photographer, and stock contributor Matt Hayward. In this quick class, we're gonna talk about a not so fun subject, rejection. You've submitted files and you were notified that some were rejected. Yes, it's frustrating and it hits hard on your enthusiasm and in some cases your ego. I get it. It happens to all contributors, myself included. Take a look at your file and decide if it's worth fixing. You can resubmit a rejected file with a modified file name after you've made corrections. When you receive a notification about a rejection, a reason is provided and you can read about additional details through the URL in the notice. I'm not going to get into all the rejection reasons here, but I will focus on the most common ones in this quick class. The rejection reason technical issue is admittedly vague and used when there are multiple issues with a photo. That can include a lack of commercial value. You need to ask yourself, why would a customer buy this image? What would they use it for? If you can't think of a good answer, try changing your approach to the content that you create and submit. And be sure to pay close attention to the details. For example, if you create a photo of a great-looking family enjoying a barbecue, but the grill is covered in rust, the photo is just not going to have any commercial value. Also note that common subjects such as flowers, pets, sunsets, and food are already very heavily represented on Adobe Stock. So if you submit content for these categories, make sure their quality stands out and that they're unique. Other causes which fall into the catch-all bucket of technical issues can be poor lighting and grain introduced to the photo, or your main subject is out of focus. Make sure that depth of field choices are intentional and effective. If you're shooting with a wide aperture, which is totally fine to do, I do it all the time, make sure the depth of field enhances the image. With shallow depth of field, important elements should not be out of focus. Also, if you've submitted multiple copies of identical or very similar content, that can be perceived as spam, and that is bad. At the very least, the files will be rejected. The rejection reason, remind to complete, most likely means that a model release or a property release is either missing or is missing important information. Please check out my Adobe Stock 101 sessions for guidance on when a model or property release is required. Often overlooked items are art on the wall in a room, logos on clothes, or recognizable tattoos. Model releases are frequently forgotten if a person is in the far distance or in a shadow. Remember, a customer who licenses your image could zoom in by cropping the image, or they can use lighting effects to increase visibility of someone in the shadows. Once you've updated or added the missing releases or edit the image to remove the item which required a release in the first place, you can resubmit it. Didn't I say that rejections provide an opportunity to learn? By now, I've become way more critical about my images and I can usually spot issues before I submit them. As a result, my rejection rate has gone significantly down from when I first started. Just remember, don't take it personal. Rejections happen to everybody. Learn from them and move on and stay creative.